I'm gonna be real with you. Cannot see any of the colors in this photo, and I'm really stressing out, and it's just really hard to edit, but like it looks, I don't know, it doesn't look okay.
Like is this okay with the, I don't even know what this is, but I in that reflection, I didn't like Photoshop that in. That's real life. I don't know. Are the colors okay?
You guys literally have no idea how hard it is sometimes to edit. Like it's literally impossible sometimes. Also, it's 10:42 in the morning and it still look like shit. You see, so here's what we're gonna do. I need to get out of the house today because I want to, I wanna write. I wanna write and I wanna work on the book and I wanna work on my podcast and I wanna work on everything. And even though this is like kind of my workspace, I don't really want to. We need to change this lens. Hold on. Okay, that's better. I wanna work on everything, but I have a hard time working on a place that's like also my bed. Like even though if I had, like, I don't care, it's not like a one bedroom or studio situation. Even if I had like a one bedroom, it's still working at home. So I think I'm gonna go to a coffee shop. It's raining outside, but I'm gonna walk to a coffee shop and we're gonna sit and write and journal and weird. Being real though, the weirdest part about writing the book and everything is that I have to be in like a certain mindset. Like I literally have to be sad right now. So I thought I was gonna cry, I had to burp. I'm gonna shower. This little segment I like to call, this goes out to all the guys who do a lot of stuff to their face in the morning, but girls just think that guys just like, do this and get ready. And I mean, I do that. Like, I don't even own a comb. Yeah, that's pretty bad. But I mean, I have to put my eyes in each day so I can see. I could wear glasses, but actually, no. We're gonna prove a point here. I literally have to take an eyeball, this plastic thing, and put it in my eye. I need the tissue and you're on the bunk, so thanks. And then I cry each morning. Each morning I cry. I have to cry to get ready. And I mean, other people have to do this too, so I can't really complain. Sometimes it just doesn't want to go in though, and you're just like, I did the same thing with the other eye, why aren't you going in? And it's just like, it's a mess. And girls, the other thing that you might not get is like, I get it, you gotta shave, you gotta shave your like, your legs and stuff, and that's normal. And then, I mean, some of you have to shave your face, I think. Yeah, no, I've heard that. But guys, some guys, like me, especially if you're Italian, you gotta look like Santa Claus, and you literally have to take a razor blade to your face every single morning. Morning if you want a clean shave. If you want to look good, you have to put this blade to your face and cut yourself. It's not easy. It's terrifying. And it just doesn't sound good. It never sounds good. Probably because I'm probably doing it wrong. Let's be real. I low-key hope I cut myself just because that'd be great clickbait. But then I guess I feel for the guys who put on makeup too, because then you gotta do all of this plus makeup. Yo, I can't even be complaining anymore. You guys win. We survived to see another day, ladies and gents. We're okay. Now the other thing is like product for your face. I don't really do much, but I do use some product. Like in the shower, I use some stuff. Like I use some Dove and some Origins and everything. And then I use kind of just like, I use moisture on my face, like moisturizer. I don't know. I don't know if this is right, but I just do it to make my, I already have like really soft skin, but it just makes me feel good. It makes me feel alive. It makes me feel like I'm ready for the day. And then for my hair, well, just, you've seen it. It just goes how it goes. All right, today is like a huge day for me. So I just tried on these pants that I've had for a couple years now. They're like Lucky Brand jeans. If you know me, like I'm a pretty skinny dude and I've been skinny my whole life and I've always like had pants that are way too big. Guys, and this isn't me trying to like show a lot of skin or anything, but like, I have to like really try to close these pants. I mean, I get them and they're tight, but like I'm growing and I've been working on my body for so long and it's so nice to see like results and stuff. Like, I don't know, I'm super happy. So today we are going for a very like earthy look to it. I don't know, I'm wearing some hot spring boots, some regular jeans that we just saw, and then like a Mandarin collar shirt to make it like a relaxed fit. I need to put on deodorant. In the moment that she walked in, wanna know everything about it. Does she still talk with her father? Or do they not speak anymore? It's the cardinal sin. The things I think about it, lasting 2 feet an hour. But I don't know which direction I'm headed in. Maybe tonight we will stand alone. Because
And now I came back home because I don't really like eating out, especially, like, I don't think I'm that bad of a cook. I don't think I'm an amazing cook, but I don't think I'm that bad. I just don't like paying, like, $20 for something that I can make for maybe $4 or $5. It doesn't make sense to me. And plus,
where I went, which is called Raw Pulp and Grind, is literally right there. So, I mean, the walking distance, like, I just gotta come up.
I also really had to pee. And I don't know, I'd rather pee at home than somewhere else. I'm weird.
Now, number one tip for eating pasta is, yes, I'm giving you tips about eating pasta. Never wear a white shirt. So I'm gonna go change.
No, are you serious? Literally, as I'm unbuttoning the shirt, like right here, there's a pasta stain because it was on my thumb. Never wear white when even looking at pasta.
And what else is new? I got the merch on. Actually, speaking of merch, I also worked on this at the Raw place. So check this out. It's definitely not done yet, but how do we feel about something like this? I don't know what I'm gonna put it on, a hoodie, a t-shirt, maybe put it on the back of something, but how do we feel? You guys keep asking for more and more merch, and I'm like, okay, if you have the money, go for it. But, yeah, stay you, for you, and do you. And I think that's, I don't know, I think that's awesome. We're going back to the stay you slogan, baby. Seriously though, like, comment down below because I'm super curious on what kind of merch you guys want to see. I don't really care about, I don't want to call it merch anymore. It's not merch, it's apparel, and it's an organization to better health.
Okay, I'm gonna be real with you. I bought Ice Crispy Square.
No.
What?
No.
I bought Rice Krispie Squares, and I've never made them. And I want to make some.
No! What did I... You know what I'm saying.
Oh my god, I'm looking at the instructions. It's literally three steps. You melt butter, you cook your marshmallows, and then you put the cereal in it, and then you just put it in a pan. Okay.
Well, I'm so dumb.
My cousin gave me these massive marshmallows, and I don't know if this is gonna be too many or too little, so we're just gonna do it.
Also, how extra am I when my butter dish doesn't open? But it's yellow. Open, goddamn, what the frick?
I put my butter in there.
Okay, I already know I'm dumb, but I don't have a glass one, like a thingy that's glass. Can I use this? I'm asking you as if I'm gonna use it anyways. It's probably not right. Mom, don't watch this. It's Rice Krispie Squared. I'm so dumb.
I'm listening to my buddy Christian Akerd right now. But my butter's melted, so I guess I'm just gonna toss these in. I don't know how many to use.
Going for it.
Do you think I know how many to add?
Like 90% of those miss.
I'm still gonna put them back in the pot.
Charlie won. Action!
I can't even put one in my mouth.
Yeah, I'm gonna eat this one.
Yes, you're in my microwave. But popular to cut. English words. Everyone thinks like I like being messy. I hate my hands dirty. And if you look at this, yeah, this looks like the most messy thing that. Oh, I'm burning it. I am burning it. It's on fire. Oh, it smells like s'mores. This is so good. Why did I say s'mores? It's s'mores. Am I still? Oh my god, I'm still on camera. Like I didn't know that. Come on, please, mom, please. I honestly think the vlog went from some pretty good content to this shit.
I didn't mean to swear there. This looks like poop, so.
Kinda makes sense.
Update, it is time to add my Rice Krispies. And I think I'm just gonna... Yep. Oh, well, shit.
My goodness.
Update, I keep stepping on frickin' Rice Krispies, and this is a sticky mess, and I hate this.
So remember when I said, like, I don't like using my hands? Yeah, I kinda just said screw it, and I'm just, oh my god, this is so hot. This is so hot. I mean, maybe it's really hot on camera, too. Are you guys attracted to me right now?
This is the hardest thing I think I've ever done in a kitchen. I think I'm making it funnier than what it actually is, because this isn't that bad. I hate sticky things. You know what? This is it. I'm done. I tried. I can say I failed, and I'm happy with that conclusion. It's not bad. I think I needed more.
Oh my god. Ew.
You know, it's good.
I'm out. Peace, bitches.
I hate cooking Rice Krispies to try to make the worst thing I've ever had to do in my whole entire life.
So what are you doing?
One, I didn't have enough of it, so it didn't fill the pan. Two, it's a sticky freaking mess, and I'm not okay.
You have to use, you put a little bit of butter on your pants.
Oh.
And then you pat it down with your hands. Whatever you use, you have to put a little butter on.
That's what I did.
Why do you not have enough? Put 6 cups of Rice Krispies in there. That's a lot of Rice Krispies.
Oh, I didn't do no measuring.
Oh. Okay.
I just used all my marshmallows, and then I kind of just used the Rice Krispie squares until they covered up the marshmallows.
Oh, big problem.
What? Long story short, yeah. I gave up on the whole, like, cooking the Rice Krispie squares, and I'm just, I'm eating cereal.
but Rice Krispies. That's my life.
Okay, I'm officially dumbed down and lazy down. I got my pajamas on with my cool socks. And I was planning on making this a bigger video, especially on my main channel. I think I'm gonna do that just because there's more of a meaning behind it than what you're about to see. I just got an email, an important email. An email that I never thought I'd see again. Well, and I didn't expect it to come like this. So a lot of people are very confused on how old I am, my age, and when I went to college, and if I graduated, and what I took. And so 2 years ago, I graduated from college. Yes, I know, I'm only 21. I wanted to take a program that was 3 years, and I did in two, so then I can get out and really focus on my YouTube and my business and my career and everything like that. So that's what I did. I took interactive multimedia design at Algonquin College, which is my local college, and it's a great school, and I love it so much. Growing up, I could never go to a school that costed a lot of money. Like, I didn't even have that as a thought, and I applied to the schools. I applied to schools like in New York, in Vancouver, in a bunch of them, and I got in. I got in, and I just wanted to know if I could make it. And I did, but I didn't choose to go because I couldn't afford it. So I always went to Algonquin. This past year, I found myself kind of bored, and I really wanted to find something new. And I kind of fell out with myself, and I had a really, really rough time. I was out calling my mom crying. I was like, who am I? Like, help me, who am I? And I was freaking out. So I applied to school again, and I won't go all into like what I applied for. It's the main thing is like, it's called brand management, so I can help manage my own brand, and I don't need anyone else to do it with me because I'm so tired of relying on others, and I'm just gonna do it myself. There was some confusion with my application, and so I emailed them and I was like, hey, can we get this fixed? And I didn't expect to receive this email. It goes, hi Josie, they called me Josie. Your Algonquin College transcripts, blah blah blah, have been sent to the brand management program, but you are missing the introductory marketing course requirement. The course that I was trying to get into, the program that I was trying to get into, I didn't even have like the level of requirements to get in. I didn't even realize that because I only took like media studies, not marketing and brand. And then I was like, oh wow, okay, well that kind of reads it for me, like I'm not getting into this. And it kind of sucked. And then I kept reading, and it goes, the program lead says that they reviewed my transcript and will accept you for the 2018 fall term for brand management based on your IMD interactive branding course. Congratulations, we accept your offer. And I was like, what? I don't know. And I know it's like not something that's like, boom, this is amazing. And I'm not somebody to get like overly excited, but it's just my heart smiled. And I didn't tell anyone I was applying to school. I think I only told my parents, and that's it. That's the only people I told, and I made it, and I got it in. And I got it in? No, I got in. I'm just really happy. Sorry I'm not like this crying, oh my God, eh. I'm just happy. Like, and I'm just comfortable, I'm happy. I'm in my PJs, I'm in my happy hoodie, and I'm just, I'm happy. Now, like, I don't want to do anything, I just want to sit, and I want to sleep. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to cook. Wait, you want to see something? This is the the updated version of the Rice Krispies squares. I mean, they're probably pretty good. I feel like I should try one. Okay, I'm really dumb. Here's why. I just tried to cut it, and then it's cold, so now I need to uncold it. I shouldn't have put it in the fridge. I'm really bad with this. This is my day of unsuccess and success. If you guys liked it, give a big thumbs up. If you want to subscribe, stay notified, hit the bell and the subscribe button, and then comment down below. I love you guys very much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Okay, no, you know what? We're gonna try this. This is my Rice Krispie square. It looks normal. It's just deformed. Yo, this is actually so good. It's like super soft. It's really good. Looks don't matter, guys. It's all about the taste. Does that work with FIFA? Okay, bye.